Mr. President, let's try that again. Mr. President, Madam Vice President, distinguished guests all, Elizabeth and Robin, Bob Dole was a Kansas native son. He, along with his hero, Dwight David Eisenhower, are Kansas's favorite son, and they represent the vision and the promise of America. Life in our state molded Bob and Ike. Open prairies, wind, always the wind, wheat fields, agriculture, where man is at the mercy of chance and weather, but can still be confident in the dignity of his labor. Bob's early life in Russell, Kansas, where the population hovered around 2,000, included the Dust Bowl and the Great Depression. Bob characterized Russell when addressing the Russell High School graduating class of 1986. He said, "There are two kinds of education in this world. There's one where you give yourself, and another you get from others. You can get an education on the farm or in a factory or in a science lab, in a church pew, most of all, if you're from Russell, you can get an education just by looking at life around you. When I was a boy, I doubt we knew the names of our congressmen or senators, but we were blessed to have friends and neighbors who knew and cared for one another. When times were tough, people were tougher. When the winds howled and part of the prairie itself was blown away, I could barely see to deliver the newspapers on my paper route. But because I came from Russell, because I came from Kansas, I was granted a special vision, one which has seen me all the years since, one which you can rely on just the same." And he defined this Kansas vision by saying, "My friends, I hope that you will never stop looking at the stars. I hope you will never forget our state motto, to the stars through difficulties. I hope that you will never stop believing in things you cannot see. I hope that your future is as hospitable and beckoning as mine was when I stood on a similar platform more than 40 years ago. I hope that in the making of life for yourselves, you won't neglect serving your country. Most of all, I hope that wherever you go and whatever you do, Russell will go with you. And for then, I know that you will be well guided." And well guided he was in attaining his vision and embodying the promise of America. When we lost Bob on Sunday, there was a pause throughout the state of Kansas as Kansans from all walks of life stopped to reflect. Bob Dole was a person who meant something to everyone in the coffee shop, the campaign trail, the halls of Congress. Whether we were in Topeka, Abilene, Wichita, or Dodge City, I saw Bob Dole connect with Kansans always on a personal level. He would share with them this vision, this promise, and he would help them to achieve it, just like the folks in Russell did in supporting him. Now, as a young staffer and later a member of the House of Representatives, following in Senator Dole's footsteps, I certainly understood Bob Dole's influence and power. On a Thursday In 1983, he would be fighting to protect Social Security with President Reagan, Senator Moynihan, others in the White House. And then on Saturday, he would be listening to Thelma in Sharon Springs, Kansas, telling him that Social Security meant to her daily life and pocketbook. And when he returned to Washington with that empathy of his and knowing Kansas and knowing Thelma, it enabled him to win the victories that he did for the disabled, for veterans, for the hungry, or for any of the issues of the day that needed negotiation, steady compromise, and the vision of America's promise. Bob never lost his common sense and famous wit. It was embedded in his nature to deliver that punchline, deadpan, knowing, waiting for the room to light up, which it always did, for the barriers to come down, letting the air out of the partisan balloons. Dole's manner and influence were so strong that if I were for something, people thought Bob was for something, and I never informed them or Bob otherwise. Well, the work we did was serious. It was a different time. There were lighthearted times, too. I would call up his chief of staff and say, "Where's my speech?" And the scramble was off to get the leader's remarks. They eventually figured it out. It was Roberts again. And I made sure my staff didn't take calls from Dole's office for the rest of the week. When his official public service came to an end, Bob could have faded away with his dear Elizabeth, telling stories, remembering the good old days, but that was not his nature. There was still so much vision and promise, still so much he could do for his fellow veterans and for his nation. Let everyone know, without Bob Dole, there would not be a World War II memorial. Bob also stressed at the time that there should also be a memorial to Ike so that veterans could salute and thank their commanding general. That effort took 24 years. And again, with Bob's help, we dedicated the Eisenhower Memorial last year. Bob Dole understood that it was just not recognition that this greatest generation deserved. It was reflection and renewal, and it was for the greatest generation to inspire the next generation. There is no better display of the vision and promise of America than every weekend when the honor flights would roll up to the World War II Memorial, Kansas veterans, escorted by Kansas high school students, would visit their memorial to reflect on their fight to preserve a free world. And there was Bob, shaking every hand, posing for every picture, listening to all the stories, and the thanks of a still grateful nation. When Elizabeth told us he passed in his sleep, and we all knew that an era had come to an end, my first reaction was one of sadness and grief, losing a dear friend and mentor. But then, thinking about it, I think the good Lord touched Bob's hand and told him it was time to come home, see his folks, that there were quite a few World War II veterans and some from Korea and Vietnam who were looking forward to thanking him, as well as folks who were disabled, quite a few dogged cat lovers, and quite a few folks from farm country, still upset about something. And a whole passel of folks from Kansas and all over, a lot of them Republicans who say they voted for him, and some Democrats who say they should have. And then he said, "Don't worry, Bob. our heavenly gates are guarded by United States Marines. So thank you, Lord, for enabling us to live in such a time and space that gave us the opportunity and privilege to know Bob Dole, a Kansas star who truly shined through difficulty.